The non 4 out of 10 pint of jiu-jitsu in Riverside. My fighting style is like water.
To South Point Arena here in Las Vegas, Nevada for more of Tough Enough, the future stars of mixed martial arts. My name is John Morgan, along with Rhonda Yakman Yakavetti, and we move on to another bout in the welterweight division. This is Lennon Zulu Ford fighting out of 10th Planet Riverside in Riverside, California, and Zulu is making his amateur debut.
Okay, well, first of all, love the name Zulu. Ford just means he's built tough. And he's a fan of GSP because he likes that he dominates and imposes his will. And yep. that's an attribute. That's one of the intangibles to everybody has a game plan, but the guys who can stick to it and adhere it more and more because of their expertise, because of their ability to adapt. That says a lot about the athlete. It is a standout thing about GSP.
And it's funny you use the word adapt there, because Lennon Ford, who trains out 10th Planet, so we know his jiu-jitsu is going to be on point, the Eddie Bravo school, but he lists his fighting style as water, as in like water. The Bruce Lee quote, obviously the Anderson Silva documentary, the ability to adapt to your surroundings. So Lennon Ford Jr. Zulu making his amateur debut.
Yeah, now adaptation is crucial in any combat sport because it doesn't always play out the way you expect it to.
Chris Silva.
My name is Chris Silva, and I'm fighting at a tap out. My fighting style is yoga for every fight. Me pulling my joints out of place to manipulate other people. I'm pretty sure the fight's going to end in a KO or a very weird submission.
Chris Silva.
Standing on the opposite side of the cage from Ford is going to be Chris Silva, 6'1" tall, originally from Ashland, Oregon, now trains out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Ron Frazier also walking into the cage, and Yakman pointing it out right there, but you know, one fighting style is water. Chris Silva's fighting style, yoga.
Yoga versus water. We could not find two more peaceful things and make them combative. But we have done it. And the Honey Badger, the nickname, by the way, for Christopher Silva, gotta love that. He is a fan of Chuck Norris. Chuck Norris, who is, you know, obviously one of the greatest martial artists of our time. And he says the sport was going to go wherever Dana White wants it to go in the next 5 years.
That's about right.
Tough to argue with that.
Tough to argue with that. Chris Silva, 32 years old, been training since he was 18. And I do love the references to Chuck Norris here. He didn't list Chuck Norris like once or twice on here. He listed Chuck Norris as his hero, his current favorite fighter, past favorite fighter. And why? Because that's the only thing a honey badger is scared of.
Nickname on your phony ID, Chuck Norris.
Chuck Norris.
Got into MMA at the age of 18, I think you said, too. That is a young age to get into MMA. And it also lets you know that the sport's actually starting to develop a little history. It's had some rings inside that tree a little bit. Because there was a point when nobody in MMA could say they got into it at 18. Not that long ago, my friend.
Not that long ago at all. Incredible to see. 14 years of training. Let's see how it pays off tonight. Let's get the official introduction of our fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight of the evening is in the welterweight division. Introducing first in the blue corner, making his MMA debut tonight, fighting out of 10th Planet Riverside, California, Lennon Zulu Ford. His opponent standing in the red corner with 3 wins and no loss, fighting out of Tap Out, Las Vegas, Nevada. He is Chris the Honey Badger. Referee in charge of the action is Chris Tione.
All right, you both have been given the rules. I expect you to obey my commands. Protect yourselves at all times. Any questions? Questions? There we go, guys. Let's go.
So welterweight matchup, Lennon Zulu Ford in the white trunks, Chris the Honey Badger Silva in the purple. Referee Chris Tione in the black.
The crowd silent in anticipation. Look at the eyes of Silva. He's assessing every inch of Ford.
Yeah, nearly caught Ford ducking in for a takedown. The high kick almost landed to the head. Did not quite do it, and so Ford was able to push in and get the takedown. Side control now from 40. Saw Chris Silva nearly nailing a beautiful sweep, trying to hip escape. Silva is extremely active from his back. He's about to get slammed. Let's go very intelligently and is now on his feet.
Great sense of balance and awareness there by Silva.
Kind of a push there more than a knockdown. A little off balance was Chris Silva and hit the deck. They restart on the feet.
A little feint there by Silva in the purple. Inside left hook by Silva, front kick. He's picking his moments.
Yeah, looks incredibly comfortable in there. And credit Ford for the aggression in the early going, getting the takedown and kind of walking through the kick to get the fight to the floor. But Chris Silva looks extremely comfortable.
Ford's got to be careful he doesn't walk into something, too, because Silva's picking his moments and probably those moments that he's coming in.
Ford did land a nice left hand there.
Uppercut pulled, almost let it go, Ford did. Big right hand swing by Silva, misses. Eats two on the chin from Ford.
That one did hurt Silva. He dives in for the takedown.
Front kick by Silva.
Well, he favors that front kick quite a bit. He's throwing it a lot. Ford, though, doing the damage with his hands. Takes an inside low kick to the cup.
Accidental shot to the twig and berries. It happens. The crowd boos. Or they're all moaning from watching it happen.
I never know when they're booing. Are they insinuating that the guy that got kicked in the groin is faking it, or is that a, or are they booing the kicker?
You know, it's probably, depending on the fight, an element of one or the other. In this case, I think they were booing Silva. I think they thought that he actually was aiming for the twig and berry shot, but I don't think that's what he was doing.
Uh-oh, looks like he might throw up. That's not good. We've got the bag out in Las Vegas. Probably won't be the only man in Sin City throw up tonight. That's okay.
No, not the first one. Probably not the last one.
Ford came in at 170, now weighing 169.
Wow.
I like it, though. He's tough.
You're not saying we're going to see a clothing line called Throw Up, are you? Throwdown's already taken.
I hope not. Lennon Ford shaking things out.
But you know what, though? Look at that guy. Look at Lennon Ford. He is not in any way considering stopping fighting. He just got it out of the way like an itch.
That's it. Touch of gloves on the restart. Chris Silva firing off high kicks. Final 10 seconds of the opening round. Lennon Ford continues to move forward with heavy hands. Winds up in top position. That's the end of the first round. An interesting first round.
And on the brow line, in that last little scurry at the end of that fight, at the end of the round, Silva got a cut on his brow line. So Ford did a little damage quickly at the end there.
Absolutely. I think Lennon Ford Jr. took that opening round quite handily. Chris Silva looks dangerous, firing off those front kicks and the high kicks as well. It looks like he could definitely do some damage with those. But Lennon Ford, heavy hands, pushing forward, being the aggressor, fought through the growing strike, and in my mind, took the opening round.
That's one of the risks you play when you try to pick your shots and do kind of what Roy Jones did with his career in boxing is if you don't do the damage when you pick those moments, if you don't deter your opponent's attack with the effectiveness of those moments, then all you have is fleeting moments that are ineffective. And that's where Ford wins the round.
All right, you see on the replays here some of the work that Chris Silva was doing, but in our minds, not enough. We've got Lennon Ford Jr. taking that opening round. So we move on to the second round here. Lennon Ford Jr. in the white trunks, Chris Silva in the purple, sporting the pinkish mauve mohawk.
Two completely different styles, too.
Another heavy right hand. Silva up, back on his feet, earns the outside trip, and look at the roll by Lennon Ford Jr. Excellent awareness. Ford backs away, content to fight this one out on the feet, and understandably so for what he's done with his hands so far.
See, that's what I'm talking about. Ford's going to be careful he doesn't walk into something. That's what I was referring to in the first round. There you go, takedown, Ford. Silva looking to use a rubber guard there. He's hugging the knee, he's pulling on the ankle.
Silva looking for the Gogo Plata.
Yes.
He's pulling down on the head. Not sure how much pressure is being generated there.
I don't know if he could generate enough with that one arm. Now he might be able to.
Rolls it over the top. Now that would have been dangerous. The inverted triangle choke. Excellent work here from Chris Silva.
Remember Eddie Bravo's thing when you mentioned 10th Planet.
Transitioning to the armbar now here as well.
Position before submission.
Lennon Ford Jr. needs to hold on to his arm. The right arm is now loose. Chris Silva in danger of winning this fight. Lennon Ford trying to keep that right arm in tight. This is a battle of wills. The arm briefly extended, but Lennon Ford gets it back. Now the triangle choke coming back.
His oxygen is not being cut off enough right now to get him to quit, but he's having a hell of a time trying to get out of this.
Incredible submission work from Chris Silva. Lennon Ford has been able to fight through it, but incredible work from Chris Silva. Going for the armbar again in the final 10 seconds. Has the right arm isolated. Can he get the elbow extended? Lennon Ford holds on until the bell. Great work on the mat from Chris Silva.
That is amazing that Silva, again, the matchmaking, he balances out the scorecards.
I guess that was that yoga that we had been hoping to see.
Yeah, and I've had people ask me to do yoga before. I am now going to continue to decline.
So I think, what do you think, Yakman? Chris Silva climbed back into the fight with that one. Several submission attempts, one after the other. None got the fight ended, but certainly dangerous moments there for Lennon Ford Jr. Was that enough for Chris Silva to take the round?
I think it was, because even though he didn't finish it, he controlled it. He controlled it. He was a heartbeat away from finishing it more than once with various positions. Arm bars, triangles, go-go plata. Took a three attempts at score. Well, all Ford did was survive, which, don't get me wrong, says a lot about him as being a prepared and skilled athlete. However, you don't get as much credit for escapes or surviving as you do for the attempts.
Absolutely not. Chris Silva was the one doing the damage, nearly ending the fight on a handful of occasions. We've got this fight even going into the third. Again, it's Lennon Ford Jr. in the white trunks, Chris Silva in the purple. What could be a decisive round here in the third. Silva continues to flash that front kick. Right hand and off balance, Chris Silva. Ford said no, thank you.
Yeah. Hey, listen, I've been to that party once. I didn't like how it worked out. Don't invite me.
Ford had gotten really kind of relying on that left lead hook. Yeah. I think Silva's seeing that and starting to duck under it and get the body lock.
But there you see, he's got to just be careful. There's a cut on that right brow of Silva. And Ford will nail that if he lands the hook. I'd like to see Ford set up some of his shots with jabs, with some movement, and not just try to launch one and move back.
Yeah, I completely agree with you. Some feints, something along those lines would be great. Because when he lands, you can see it does bother Silva.
Yeah, he's doing some effective shots when he does them. But if he doesn't one at a time, it's easy to get out of the way, counter it, and take over for Silva.
More combination work there for Lennon Ford. Working inside, eats a knee. Silva slips and falls, but he's back up. Final 40 seconds of this fight. Still anybody's match at this point. Silva pushing in on the outside, clinching against the cage. Obviously would like to get the fight to the floor after the incredible work that he did in the second round. Showed that he is certainly the more skilled fighter in the jiu-jitsu department. Ford switches this into a single leg. Drives forward with a huge takedown.
Silva gets slammed. But now he's working the guillotine.
Yeah, Silva alertly grabbed the neck, tried to lock in the guillotine choke as he hit the ground. Ford is going to finish this fight on top as Silva lays back, trying to finish this guillotine choke. No pressure on the neck. Lennon Ford lasts until third. Highly entertaining fight between these two welterweights. Ron, the Yak Man, who do you have taking this third and final round?
Man, again, a close call. I almost want to lean Silva.
I'm going to go the opposite way. I'm going with Lennon Ford. I think the late takedown, although he did fall into a guillotine choke attempt, it wasn't a deep one. I thought he did a little bit better on the feet in the third and final round. I'm going to go with Lennon Ford. So we're split here in the broadcast booth. We'll see if the judges are split as well. It was certainly an entertaining fight, back and forth from start to finish. Lennon Ford Jr. showed some heavy hands, maybe got a little too simplistic in his approach, wasn't really setting things up as he continued. Chris Silva in the second round showed incredible jiu-jitsu. We're going to watch a replay of some of the action here in the third. Silva again was flashing that high kick. This was the second round that almost ended the fight with these nasty armbar attempts, but Lennon Ford Jr. was able to survive them. Great work back and forth from both fighters. Again, we're split here in the broadcast booth. Let's see what the judges think. Let's take it up to Justin Bernard to get our official result.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of war, we have your winner by split decision, the blue corner, Lennon Zulu Ford.
Lennon Zulu Ford gets the victory over Christopher Silva, the Honey Badger, and it was that close. We were divided. I even hesitated to even say Silva, but I thought the submission work might have done a little bit more for him. I tell you what I'd like to see, more action between these guys at a rematch, and more action still coming up here at Tough Enough, the future stars of mixed martial arts. Just as good as this, don't go anywhere. We'll be back right after this.
Fight went good, it didn't go like I expected it. There we go, there he is. But you know what, I'll be back to claim heads, kick ass. You know what? Being from 10th Planet, submissions don't scare nobody at the gym. So they can throw whatever it is. We know the escape. So
Sean Bollinger and Jeremy Fields, Sean, right there.
That's it. That's it. Chad Bollinger, hands coach. A better win. I said I was going to get a win. Now it's going to be a better win. Maybe even submission if they let us do twisters. The belt's already mine. It's just getting it. That's it.
Somebody else is holding it right now.
Somebody else has it right now. They're keeping it warm. They're coming after it.
Fight fans, are you ready for a war?